Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, with our main topic today. We're discussing today UK resuming flights back to Egypt in Sharm el Sheikh Airport. To shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to host today Dr. Mohammed Abdelaziz, the international tourism expert. Welcome
to you and to the viewer. Thank you very much.
Well, Dr. Abdelaziz, now this is a very important decision taken by the UK to lift the ban on the UK flights to Sharm el-Sheikh.
Normally, there were no ban for Hurghada and for the rest of the destinations in Egypt. But actually, the ban was only for Sharm el-Sheikh because of the events of the flights of the Russian flights which took place on 2016. But actually, we are running in Sharm el-Sheikh nowadays without having resuming the flights back from UK. We do have around 60 to 70% occupancy.
Yes.
Meanwhile, we are having on the Red Sea area between 90% and 100% occupancy.
Yes.
Of course, this is a great news to resume the flights back from the UK market.
Yes.
And of course, it will increase the number of tourist nights and the number of tourists coming to Egypt. But we have to take care of what we have to do now.
Yes.
Because normally, very near, we hope also that the flights will resume also from the Russian market.
So, Dr. Abdelaziz, when the flights are back again and the UK resumes its flights, what are the steps that we should take when the English people are back to Sharm el-Sheikh?
Not only in Sharm el-Sheikh, because I'm quite sure that the volume of business between the British market and the Egyptian market,
yes,
will increase in many other destinations, not only in Sharm el-Sheikh. But what we have to do first is to get ourselves ready. To,
yes,
get ourselves ready, I mean here that we should pay more attention for our properties. I mean here the hotel and resort properties.
Yes.
Most of which do need a very quick renovation in order to be ready to have this number of tourists,
yes,
back to their destinations.
Yes.
On the other hand, we do have a very critical situation in the tourist market here. It is about the staffing. We do have a very lack of skilled staff in our properties. And this what we have to do first, to have enough skilled people to serve those people when they are come back, hopefully within next months,
yes,
inshallah.
Yes.
The point here is we have to think a little bit outside the box. We have to think about launching a new academy, that can take care of, let me say it, take care of having newcomers to the tourist industry. I mean here people who are not working yet in the tourism industry. We have,
yes,
to take those people and to train them, and to train them on a certain position or a certain role in
rules,
the tourism industry. I mean here that by the end of the day we will have a skilled person,
yes,
who knows very well what to do, who knows very well how to deal with tourists, who know very well how to act with the different cultures and the different nationalities that,
yes,
we will expect to have in our country.
Yes, to have a certain mentality to deal with the tourists. Yes. So, Dr. Abdelaziz, let me just quote the Dr. Rania Al-Mashat, the Minister of Tourism. Her reaction after hearing this announcement by the UK, Her Excellency Dr. Al-Mashat said, "We welcome the return of British tourists to Sharm el-Sheikh. This announcement is a renewal of the ongoing cooperation between both nations." She also, Her Excellency, she added that this step is a testament to the continuous efforts exerted by the Egyptian government to ensure safety and security of every visitor in all Egyptian destinations, and especially in South Sinai.
This is
so what's your comment?
Yes, this is quite very important. I think, in my opinion, it's a long-term patronage between
yes,
the two governments. British will never stop coming to Egypt, and we will be hosting them forever, inshallah. The point here, what Her Excellency just highlighted, is the safety and the security. And this, what should we do first?
Yes.
A very special attention should be given to the hotel properties,
yeah.
And especially when it comes to the quality of service offered,
yes.
And to be sure that no one will get hurt or get anything that will just will not be convenient for him whenever he will come to our to any of our destinations. Normally, food safety in hotels, we should pay attention for this topic. This is very important.
Yes.
Food safety and the staffing. We have to arrange new staffing for the incoming period in order to be ready to serve those people when they will come back.
And also the safety and the security measures taken in the airport. Yes, that was very important.
Yes, of course. It was one of the conditions for, from the UK government.
Yeah.
But let me tell you that, in other words, this was not only applied in Sharm el Sheikh. This is applied all over Egypt. And thanks God, this is due to the efforts done by the President of the Republic and the Army that we are enjoying nowadays a very good reputation about our safety and the security, and this is one of the major points that will attract back tourists to come back to Egypt.
Yes, so Dr. Abdelaziz, what would be the echo of this announcement by the UK lifting the ban on the flights to Sharm el Sheikh in regaining confidence to one of the most important destinations in the world, which is Egypt, with its great civilization and monuments?
We will have to think that most of other people will follow the UK government.
Yes.
And I'm pointing here to the Russian government.
Yes, that's very important because a large number of Russians are really living in Sharm el Sheikh or are very...
As a matter of fact...
The largest number of tourists are Russians and then Germans after this.
Yes, nowadays Germans are number one. And then comes Italians and the Ukrainians. We do not have Russians in any destinations in Egypt for the time being. They do have only flights coming to Cairo.
Yes.
But I'm quite sure that hopefully within the next few days or maximum 1 month, I'm quite sure that the Russian government will follow the UK government on resuming back the flights to the Egyptian destination. I would like to say that Russians do consider the Red Sea area as if it is their backyards. They do love to live there. Sometimes when they come to visit the place and when they enjoy the sun and the sea, you will have that feeling that they do not want to go back to their countries again.
Yes.
The wound they will have from the treatment of the Egyptian people, and especially in the Red Sea area, I mean here, that they would like to stay there. And believe it or not, when they will come, when they will have the time to check out and to go back to their countries, you will notice that they are very sad that they are leaving our country and the sun and the sea we are having here.
Yes. So despite the large number of monuments and the great civilization in Egypt, located in Luxor, Aswan, Cairo, the Sphinx, the pyramids, still the tourists likes very much the beach tourism in Sharm el Sheikh. How can we promote more for this tourism?
Normally, if we will just serve people who are coming to our countries with a quality of service, those people, when they will go back to their countries, they will do the promotion and they will do the advertising we need to do. We used to call this the positive word of mouth.
So it's a matter of increasing the number of tourists coming to Egypt. As long as we increase this number, they are going to promote more and more to when they go back to their homeland.
Of course, because whenever you will go back to your homeland, you will meet your friend, you will meet your colleague, you will meet your neighbors, and you will tell them about the story you spent and about the holiday you spent in Egypt, how it was nice, how people were nice to you. And this is why I was in particular highlighting the part of the staffing and the part of getting them ready to host those people when they come back. Because people in the tourism industry, we used to say that tourism industry is a service-based industry. And we have to admit that the backbone of this industry is the human factor.
Yes.
If we do not have skilled people to serve those people when they will come to our destination, it means that we are sending negative message to their homeland when they will go back. And we have to highlight the importance of the human factors and to take good care of it. I think that more attention should be given to the human factors working in the tourism workforce all over Egypt.
Yes.
Training. Benefits. I have to say that
the mentality and the culture of the receiving the tourist.
Yes,
and treating him.
We have to put into our consideration as well that the salaries are still not up to the required up to the requirements of the people working in the industries. So a point which should be highlighted here is the salaries of the workforce working in the industry as well.
Yes. So, Dr. Abdelaziz, in your point of view, what makes Sharm el-Sheikh a very special destination, despite that there are no monuments there? What makes it
the nature,
the mountains and the atmosphere?
The nature itself. The nature itself is enough for them. The atmosphere, the climate, the sun, the sea. And especially this part of Egypt is a holy part, because if you will go a little bit further to Taba and to St. Catherine and to the area around, it's a holy land. It's where God were speaking to God Moses, and you will find that people will just maybe come to visit this part of the city. Also, in other places, we have the route of the Holy Family, which was in the area in St. Catherine as well. This is not only because of the sun and the sea and the spirit of the people as well. If you will go to any other touristic destination and you will find that people are ignoring you and they do not serve you as much as you want, believe it or not, you will never go to this place again. But if people are hosting you well, if whenever you will need anything, they will obey and they will bring it to you, you will think about returning back to this destination. And whenever you will return back, you will tell others to come with you. And others will obey you. If you will just post some photos on Instagram or on any or Facebook or Twitter, people will follow how much you are happy, and they will be more than happy to come and to take that experience for them as well.
Yes, yes. So, Dr. Abdelaziz, with Egypt now establishing, or it's about to be finished, the Grand Egyptian Museum that encompasses a large number of Egyptian monuments. How can we promote for this, and how would this a very grand Egyptian museum and very precious one would promote and boost the tourism in Egypt?
I think the efforts spent by the Ministry of Tourism and the Ministry of Antiquities are quite up to the required standard and even more.
Yes.
Last year in the ITBE in the World Market in Germany, they did promote the Grand Egyptian Museum on the tickets of the of the events itself.
Yeah.
It was actually a brilliant idea, and I do recommend to host some celebrities from all over the world whenever we are about to do the opening of the because you know quite well, when we do have celebrities visiting a place, people sometimes will come to accompany these celebrating and to see how they act, how they walk, and so on.
I thank you very much for your valuable information. Unfortunately, our time is up. I thank you very much, Dr. Mohammed Abdelaziz, the international tourism expert. Thank you very much for your time, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, this, my dear viewers, we come to the end of this episode of our program, Cairo Local Time. I'm Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.